Hi everyone! In this video, we'll show you how to edit legacy.vsd files in Visio for the web without losing your data. Let's show you how it works. First, you'll need to upload your .vsd file to OneDrive, if you haven't already done so. Then, open the file in your browser and either select the Edit in Browser button in the message bar, or select the Edit in Browser option from the Edit Diagram dropdown in the ribbon. If you click on the Edit in Browser button from the message bar, a copy of the .vsd file will be created and saved in the current .vsdx file format, in the same location as the original file, with the same file name. By creating a copy, you can preserve the original file and edit the new file in the web app. You can do the same by selecting the Edit in Browser option from the Edit Diagram dropdown. Please note that the .vsdx file format does not support macros. If your .vsd file has macros, they will not be preserved in the copy. The copy of the .vsd file will then open for editing in Visio for the web. From here, you can edit any text, shapes, colors, or layout in the web app, and enjoy all the benefits of Visio for the web, such as autosave, co-authoring, and sharing. And that's it. You have successfully edited a .vsd file online with Visio for the web. If you have the Visio in Microsoft 365 license, you will need to upgrade to either Visio Plan 1 or Visio Plan 2 to edit .vsd files in Visio for the web. You can also see a list of features available with your Visio Plan 1 or Visio Plan 2 subscription by visiting the Visio comparison page. You can start your 30-day free trial today by visiting the link in the description below. We hope you find this feature useful. We would love to hear from you. Visit the Visio feedback portal. Or share your feedback directly in the Visio web app using the Give Feedback to Microsoft option. Thanks for watching, and thank you for choosing Visio for the web. See you next time.